I have something here for you. Tidings that may displease you.
Tell me.
You remember Kjotve's son, Gorm? He has since taken his father's place in the Order.
Interesting. He's got him here in England. Is he another Blotch on our list?
He is one of our targets, yes. But he is not in England. He is further west, in fact. A land called Vinland, discovered centuries ago by an Irish sailor called Brendan. The Order of the Ancients has some recent fascination with Vinland, but I cannot say what it might be.
Let me find out for you, after I silence Gorm.
Vinland is far away, according to my source. It may take weeks to find him after a long and perilous journey.
There's no danger that would cow me, Aetham. I will speak with Ranvi and arrange passage.
Was there something else?
I have to go.
Then go in peace.
Good to see you, darling.
Come to me. Should we take this to your chamber?
No need.
I want to see the Alliance map.
Have you spoke with Hytham about Vinland?
I have.
Good. I have marked it on the map with a bit of guesswork as to its location. Let me know when you wish to leave.
Those Dane invaders. They came from East Anglia, is that right?
Yes. Dane invaders who serve a man called Ruard. He seems to be sowing discord among Saxons and friendly Danes alike. Years ago, the sons of Ragnar hoped to pacify the land. They appointed a steward named Finnir to find a suitable Saxon king. But the kingdom has fallen into ruin since, with no king, and violent raiders ravaging what little peace remains. I suggest you make for East Anglia and find out what their steward is doing wrong.
We'll make the trip east, then. Speak to this Finnir myself.
A good plan.
Ah, hey, my boy.
Good day to you. You and Petra chasing a white elk in the woods high as wispy clouds, my god! I could barely breathe for laughing.
Beautiful, beautiful. Nature is amazing. happy to say I've refreshed my stocks.
I'm off. Be well, friend.
Until next time.
Petra.
Eivor, how are you?
Thought we might spend some time together.
That would be lovely. I was just about to get in some archery practice, if you'd like to join me.
I could use the practice. Lead on.
Remember, you can only shoot a target once. Ready? Go!
Right in the middle.
Ah, not bad. Ah, not bad. Ha! Bullseye! I dare you to do better. To do better.
And I believe the victory goes to me.
Good game. That was fun. Next time, could we light the arrows afire or shoot blindfolded?
I'm satisfied with ordinary arrows. Less chance for disaster.
Fair enough. I look forward to it.
I'd like to see what you have in stock.
I'm practically giving it away. I'll be sure to keep this in stock for you. For you. a pleasure doing business, Eivor. Is that everything?
I must be on my way now. Goodbye.
Until next time, Eivor.
Fyrir spár sagði.
Það er rétt væri að nefna. Þeir freistu að kaupa.
What? What's happening?
Finian?
No, not unless Halfdan sends you.
I sent myself. I want to speak with Finnir, the steward who should be working to put a king on that throne.
You're in luck then, for I have found the man already. I'm only waiting on him to get married.
Which man?
You know, stranger, you interrupted a beautiful dream. I was sailing through Helheim, drifting on a ship of fire.
Dreams of death often run ahead of the real thing.
Oh, wouldn't that be a burden off my shoulders? What business have you with the backwater king, anyway?
Danes from here attacked my clan. I want to know why, and how to make sure it never happens again.
Ah, that would be Ruud's clan. They killed the last man I put here, Adolstan. I suspect they'll do the same to our next monarch.
A Dane who can't keep the Danes in line. Not much of a steward, are you?
If I knew how, I'd have rid our lands of them long ago. Ruud's clan plagues us all, Dane and Saxon alike.
You are the sorriest soldier I've met in this country. Kick your king in the arse and fight back.
He needs more than a kicking. He's got nothing he should have to win this fight. No courage, no army, no charisma. If he wants to live longer than a season, he'll need the backing of his bride's family, which he hasn't. They loathe the maggot.
Who is he, your King Maggot?
Oswald of Elmenham. He was King Edmund's counsel before the invasions. And like it or not, he's the last Saxon noble with any sway.
Why not crown a Dane instead?
Halfdan Jarl made it clear. He wants a Saxon king married to a Dane, for a greater show of unity. But Oswald's not the sort of man you'd chase into battle with a grin. He's soft, and the settled Danes don't trust him.
Where is he now? I'll get the measure of him, see what I can do.
You just missed him. He's headed for Elmenham just now, pleading once again for peace. If you go by the north gates and along the road, you may catch him.
As they went.
It wasn't us.
I built myself a home here. Ruid's clan attacked us as well.
Oh, how nice to have a home to speak of, man. Mine was burned to the ground years ago. And by whom, I wonder?
Please, all of you, be we Dane or Saxon, we all want the same peace, with land to till and home to keep, without fear of Ruid's violence.
Till they break the peace with another bleeding raid.
Nonsense. Their homes are here now. Same as ours, our futures run together, not apart.
So what are these Danes attacking us, eh? What will you do about them?
When I am king... when I am your king, I'll set things right.
You will be king when I am a flying troll.
You handled that well. Disputes between Saxon and Dane don't always end so cleanly.
That was a clean result.
A dispute ending without bloodshed is as clean as they come.
Quite a brutal outlook.
I'm Eivor of the Raven Clan. Are you Oswald?
I am. You're not here to kill me, are you?
I'm not in the habit of killing kings, but I do like meeting them.
I am Oswald, yes, for as long as I can hold out.
So what happened here, Oswald?
A clan led by a Dane called Ruid attacked this morning. They've been sacking farms and hamlets across East Anglia for some time now, growing more brazen by the day.
Do they know this is Halfdan's land?
They must. They just don't care.
Their chaos has touched my home as well, and I'm here to see that it doesn't happen again. Lately, I've come to learn that you are the hook that all hopes hang upon. As king, you could unite all the Saxons and friendly Danes.
A minor weight to bear, isn't it?
Who else, if not a king, should bear it?
Travel with me, Eivor. We can discuss my tenuous future on the road home.
What begs your attention in Elmenham?
Wedding preparations. Elmam is on guard as we ready my marriage to the Dane woman Valdis. She's a cousin of Halfdan's.
Good. A well-matched marriage can forge a strong alliance. So what's the holdup?
The holdup? I don't yet have permission to marry Valdis. Her brothers don't approve of me. Slow down. Something is not quite right here.
Hold. There's smoke ahead.
That's Beatley. It could be the same men who attacked at the walls of Norwich.
Stay here. I'll have a look. They will attack on sight here.
Stop right there.
Ah!
I never knew you as a man given to verse.
Ah, their little worries, their little lives. They mean nothing to me. They're flies. Shit. You're like that.
Ruid's clan. They left none alive.
God rest their souls. I'm needed at home to make yet another fruitless attempt to impress my betrothed family.
Show more grit than you're showing me now, and they may start to like you.
Yes, sorry, I'm just shaken. If you joined us at dinner, that might ease their minds a touch. Think about it. My doors are open to you.
I'd be happy to join you. Tell me when and where.
Wonderful. Visit us in Elmham whenever you have time.
It's worse here than I feared. Healthy seeming town. This Oswald has done well for himself.
Look there. A lone Dane. Can't trust that.
Shh. Be kind, yeah? As Christ would command.
Oswald! Where's this dinner you promised me?
Eivor! You came! Dinner will still be served, but I'm afraid you are too early. My intended and her family are not ready.
This intended of yours, Oswald. Who is she? One of love or politics?
Her name is Valdis, and people don't marry for love these days, Eivor. This is an arrangement for East Anglia's benefit. She's from a Dane family whose military might is not to be trifled with, but her brothers, their motives are selfish. Why don't you have a look around and come back later? Dinner will not disappoint.
Thank you.
lords, ladies, this is a day of peace and fraternity. I asked you here to Elmenham to offer my thanks and extend my generosity. Finir, our steward, to our guests of honor, Brothir and Brodir, and to my lovely bride-to-be, Valdis.
You get to plow our sister because Halfdan commands it. But you won't drag us into bed with you, you hear?
Brodir,
the last Saxon king we backed wasn't half as mushy as you, and we lost 150 men protecting his maggoty arse.
Brodir.
If you're going to be rude, then I must ask you to leave. This is my home, and won't be insulted here.
Is that why you've come? To back this Thane who smells of goat shit and cheap pebbles.
I'm sorry, did you say something?
Do I bore you, Wolfkist?
I'm here to protect my clan. If that means helping your king secure his throne, well, so be it.
You'd be safer crowned with the throne.
It's made of less wood than this one.
We'd all be safer if you had the stones to stand up to Ruid's clan. Between the pair of you, can't see a single nugget.
You watch your tongue, Wolfkist, or you'll find it freed of your face.
So easily wounded by words. Imagine the ruin my axe would inflict on your flaccid ego.
My flaccid what? Please stop this.
You heard me.
That's it.
She called us flaccid!
Slim, weak, soft.
Ruid, that's he said.
Stop! All of you! That's enough fun for tonight.
If that's all you've got, it's little wonder East Anglia's in the state it is.
You are weak, sheepherder. Your Norse friend here can't change that. We are better off without a king.
Well, that's me done.
I think I prefer dream nonsense to these alehouse brawls.
What a waste of time and good mead. These brothers will never back me in my claim.
This dance is just beginning, Oswald. Get some rest. You'll need your energy.
And will I see you in the morning? We have much to discuss, I think.
I will find a place to lay my head.
And, Eivor, if you can help me right this situation, you'll have a strong alliance with East Anglia. That much, I promise.
Seems Oswald has set out for the day. I should have a word with him.